Okay. We appreciate the love and support that all of you have given us during this time. It's been incredible to see the outpouring of love that has been shown to us. The day after Joe died, we had 25 kids show up to our house. Family and friends have come from California, Colorado, Ohio, and more to offer support, and we thank all of you for that. I would like to touch on a few things about my son for those of you who did not know him well. Joe is the kind of guy that if he walked into the room, you knew it. He made his presence known wherever he went. He stood tall and with his shoulders back. He had that kind of swag to him as he walked into a room. He had a great big personality and he could easily talk to people. We are finding out that he kept in touch with way more people than we ever knew. If you were part of Joe's inner circle and you understood him, you knew that he loved you and he wanted the best for you and would do anything for you. Joe liked playing the role of protector. Even when my kids were young, if another little boy was giving his little brother John a problem, Joe pushed them down the slide at the McDonald's play place. And there was very little chance that his little sister Eliza was having a boyfriend in high school. Other boys knew not to mess around with Eliza. She would complain, "Mom, I can't even go out on a date." I told her, "Sorry, Eliza, you'll have to wait until Joe and John have graduated. That's just the way it is." Joe was baptized in the Methodist Church as an infant. We came to this church on Sundays. He came to Vacation Bible School here and was confirmed here on this stage. He went to Victory Christian Academy for 7th and 8th grade and had Bible class each day. Joe knew God. And Joe had a wonderful, big, loving heart. Ooh, as the kids became older, we didn't go to church much. It seemed kind of life got in the way, work got in the way. Like it's time we come back to the church. Joe had struggles in his life for many years. Many of you know his struggles. It was extremely hard for all of us for many years. He made tremendous growth these last few years. He found a job he absolutely loved. He finally found a place where he fit perfectly and he belonged. A father-son relationship that was much damaged was repaired right in front of our eyes. They had found a newfound respect for each other. Then he found Vanessa. He had new love in his life, a new trust in his life, and they were planning for the future. This was the happiest I've seen him. It makes me happy that he got to experience these things. He was coming along. He just had one more thing to conquer. Our family friend Mike Sutter came to our house the other day. Where are you, Mikey? Are you here? Thanks, buddy. I love you. He came to drop off a meal for us. He expected to make a quick delivery, but it ended up being a longer stay than anticipated. You see, Mike is going through his own struggles, as many of us are. We're trying to make sense of things in our life, and sometimes it just doesn't. Mike shared his thoughts on spiritual warfare, and he believes it's going on this day and age. Mike added, "I always saw Joe as a leader. The devil is trying to get those Joe Tanishes. He's trying to get those big personalities, those leaders he wants on his side. But God stepped in and snatched Joe up and said, 'You can't have this one. Not anymore. Joe's coming to fight my army now, and he has some really, really big wings on. You'll be a leader in my army.' Thank you, Mike, for your words. They gave me comfort. I can picture that. There are many wonderful memories of Joe. One of them, when a child stands out, he was about 5 years old. It was a warm summer day, and he wanted me to come outside with him. He took his blanket and placed it on the front step of the house. He smoothed it out for me. Then he came back inside to get me. He was so excited for me to be there with him. I remember it well. He wanted to make a special place for me. He grabbed my hand and said, 'Come on, Mom, come on, Mom, come with me.' He kept repeating, "Come on, Mom, come with me," as he held my hand and led me to a special place he had prepared. And that's how I picture it when my time comes. I can picture Joe being so excited to see me. I can picture him with a great big smile and reaching out and taking my hand, saying, come on, Mom, come with me. And having that special place smoothed out and prepared in God's army just for me. I love you, Joe. I'll always be your mom. And you'll always be my loving son forever in my heart.
I should have wrote it down. I think that when Joe was born, he didn't want to come out of Mom. It was during a Bulls game on a Sunday, and the doctor would just come in at halftime and at the end of the third quarter to see how Amy was doing, and it was rough. I'd never experienced any kind of childbirth before, but wow. He was just a little squirt. I just remember being on the kitchen floor and downward facing dog just blowing bubbles, and he was content with doing that for 10 minutes and 20 minutes. That was just him. Then the school age came, and school's for some people, and it's not for others, like me and like Joe. And we had our struggles through that. But one of my proudest days, because he didn't want to do it, but we got a gown on him and he graduated, and I was so proud of him, because I knew it took a lot for him. Not that he wasn't smart enough to do it, but just wanting to go there and do it, you know, with everything. Yeah. I was fortunate enough to have him work with me and to be able to drive in these last 2.5 months. We spent a lot of time together. We drove in together. We would work 18, 19 days and drive home together. And we were getting along. I kind of knew when to be quiet when he wasn't talking, and he knew the same thing with me. And it wasn't always like that. I heard demons. He had some things. He'd get in trouble. And I could just see that it just takes a little while for other people to outgrow that. And he was outgrowing it. Talked to the other captains that were there. There was quite a few of them there yesterday, and every one of them said that he was a pleasure to have on board. He had a great attitude. I never heard him complain. And in a sea full of, you know, professional complainers, that really stood out. You know, he was. I guess I should have wrote more down. But there's just so much going on in my brain with it all. It was hard last night because I keep thinking that maybe he's in trouble and he's going to be back in 30 to 90 days. And it's just not the fact. And John and Eliza, I'm so proud of you both. You know, yesterday when all this started and there was a big line starting to come through that door, Eliza was on the point. She was the first greeter, and it came overwhelming, and then John came up and took it, and I was kind of told to stand over here, so I did. I was so proud of them. It took so much courage to do that. But courage is one thing that Joe had. He was a great friend to have on your side, and he's somebody that you didn't want on your ass. going to be about it. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.
Hello, everyone. I first want to thank Pastor Heather and the church for this beautiful service, and the Tanish family, Amy, Steve, John, and Eliza, for letting me speak today. I had the privilege of getting to know our sweet Joseph for the past 7 months. Although it wasn't at all enough, I'll forever cherish our time together. It started when Joe and I reconnected on December 11th via social media, after not seeing each other since club swimming when he was still wearing a tiny Speedo, where I commented on one of his many muscle photos and said, "I'm definitely stronger than you." For any and all who knew Joseph will know he took that as a challenge, and he invited me over the next day looking to have a push-up competition, and I think we all know who won. It was me, and most likely because he let me. From there on, Joseph and I spent every waking moment together. Depending on our work schedules, he took me to beautiful dinners where he wouldn't let me pay because that's the gentleman he was. Made me feel so special and loved, made me laugh until I cried, called me every second he had the chance, only to tell me he was thinking of me. He wouldn't let me forget how beautiful I was, but most of all, he protected me. He protected me from myself. I struggled to find a job after graduation due to COVID, and he motivated me and believed in me more than anyone. Joe encouraged me every day to go back to school and pursue my master's because supposedly I was the smartest person he knew. I think he was just trying to make me feel good, but nonetheless, I believed him and will be applying for my master's next fall. This is all coming from someone who didn't attend college. Joe helped me realize you don't have to go to college to be intelligent and to find an occupation that you love. Anyone who had Joe on Snapchat would see that every day. He loved what he did and was complimented often on how talented he was for his age. Joe will always be the hardest working person I've ever met. He might have had a funny way of showing it, but all he wanted was the best for everyone around him. He tried to help myself and others drive their success based off of his. And let me tell you, it really worked. Never was there a time that I questioned our love for one another because I knew we were a match made in heaven. Grandma Schick always told us. I wasn't allowed to open doors for myself, carry more than one grocery bag, or go to sleep without Joe telling me he loved me while simultaneously throwing his cat Cheddar, who I'm allergic to, at my face and giving me the nickname Kitty because he thought it was hilarious. And it was. Joe would poke fun at my allergies, called me a blind bat every chance he had while trying to make me pick out distances on the highway that he could tell and I couldn't. And he wouldn't let me live down the amount of sweat that I could perspire while walking Czar down the street. Above all else, Joe's humor came from his antagonistic but always playful tendencies that I will miss the most. He was one of the smartest, most gracious men I knew. He did a lot for myself and his family. He was my world, and my life will quite simply never be the same without him. We had started making plans, life plans together that I will continue to carry on for the both of us. There won't be a day where I don't think about my sweet Joseph and how hard he fought every day to be the best version of himself. Time is never guaranteed, and I hope we all learn the lesson to never take anything or anyone for granted. Hug your loved ones as tight as you can today, because I would do anything for one last hug with the man that I love most. The greatest life lesson Joe taught me that I want to share with all of you today is about control. He often reminded me if something wasn't making me happy in my life, I needed to woman up and take control of my own life because nothing worth living for falls in your lap. You have control over any and all decisions that are made in your life, he would tell me. So why not choose happy, Vanessa? Be in control of your life every day. And know when a change needs to be made to better yourself and never hand someone the steering wheel that drives your success. But simply know when someone like Joe is there to motivate you down the right path. Joseph is in heaven now with his big and beautiful angelic wings. I know he's with Grandpa Schick and his Grandma Janet, asking them to climb aboard his tugboat and navigating them on a beautiful journey. I'll never forget you, Joe, and I'll always be by your side, just like our song says. I love you with everything I am. Until we hold each other again, love always, your Nesquik. Thank you.
Thank you. 364.